Assalamu alaikum. My beloved students, how are you all? Hope you all are fine by the kindness of Allah the Exalted. I am also fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Welcome to NIVS Home School. This is Wahid Noor, Assistant Teacher of Islamic Studies, National Ideal English Version School, Deshit. Today, I am going to conduct the class of Islamic Studies for class 8. And today, our topic is MCQ and CQ1. And that is from exercise, chapter 4. This is lecture number 11. And also HW number 11 is there. And annual time is going on. My dear students, last few classes, last 10 classes already, we have finished the discussion from chapter 4. And that was about the akhlaq. And already we informed about the akhlaq-e-hamida and akhlaq-e-zamima. And rest of many of the information we gathered. But today we will solve from the exercise MCQ and first creative question, and there is four question A, B, C, D. Okay, let's start. Students, you open your book, page number 117. This is your page of your book, page number 117. And there is the multiple choice question. It means MCQ. So I am not explaining this by reading the questions. But you know the answer. First question is, how many kinds of brotherhood are there? You know, there are three kinds of brotherhood. Three. Now, question number two, which of the following includes social service? There are three sentences. Which of the following includes social service? Any one or any two or all? So, answer is all. If you read the answer, then you can understand. All are, will be answer. So D is the answer. Now read the following passage and then answer the question number 3 and 4. Mr. Abdul Rahman is a high-ranked officer in an office. He is experienced too due to working for a long time. He gets angry and uses indecent language even if his colleagues make silly mistakes. He never repents also for this kind of behavior. So, according to this discussion, we can understand the officer of that office, Mr. Abdul Rahman, he was not the decent person. He used the bad language. So, what does Mr. Abdul Rahman symbolize? That is indecency. And question number 4, according to the passage, what will be the consequence of Mr. Abdul Rahman's act? That will be A, gaining hatred of the people. It means every people will hate him. That he will gain. So A is the answer. Well, now students, see attention to the creative questions. As you know, at first you have to read calm and quietly the stem. Then according to the stem, you have to give the answer of C and D. And as you know, A is the knowledge-based question. It means you have to read all the sentences from your textbook, then you can give the answer of A. And B, understanding-based questions. For giving the B answer, also you have to read the book, textbook. But C and D, for giving the answer, you have to read the stem calm and quietly. And you have to understand what he are saying. So I am reading, Mr. Naim established an agricultural farm spending an amount of taka 5 lakhs. Different crops have been produced in this farm. His neighbor, Mr. Shishir, felt a kind of pain in his heart observing the production of crops in Mr. Naim's farm. Most of the crops of Mr. Naim's farm were destructed by a prolific cyclone before the harvesting was done. This made Mr. Shishir very happy. This made means the harming or the harvest the destruction of the Mr. Naim's crops, this made Mr. Shishir very happy. But Mr. Naim was not upset at all for the devastation in the farm. He said, I mean Mr. Naim said, it is the assessment by Allah. I want to pass in Allah the Almighty's assessment. So according to the passage, according to the stem, we can understand Mr. Naim spent 5 lakh taka only for harvesting the for the agricultural crops. But one day that all crops has been destroyed by the cyclone. So it was the natural activities, natural act. So Mr. Naim think it is Almighty Allah's test. And those are the moments Allah will fail them in this type of dangerous examination, dangerous test. And if they become patient, then they will be success. On the other hand, Mr. Shishir, they are becoming envy, becoming jealous, and which is not allowed in the Islamic Sharia. So according to this stem, we will discuss from C, we will give the answer C and D. Well, so the first question is, what is the Arabic term of hatred? Students, in your book there is this word, but I cut there because this is your out of syllabus of short syllabus. We made the short syllabus, we didn't discuss from that chapter. That's why I cut that and I added at there social service. What is the Arabic term for social service? So see the answer. The Arabic term of social service is khidmatul mujtama'i. I written there khidmatul mujtama'i. This is the answer. So khidmatul mujtama'i means social service. Now see the B question. What is meant by pride? Explain. For this, 2 marks. Answer is, the synonym of the word of pride is vanity, arrogance, boast, etc. In your book, you will get more synonym, but I add there only 3. So, having a falsely high estimation of oneself or considering others as ordinarily inferior is called pride or vanity. Students, in the question, they are said, what is meant by pride? What is meant by pride or what is meant by vanity? All are same answer. The person who takes pride or vanity is called proud. In Arabic, it is called Al-Kibr. I written there Al-Kibru, or you can say Al-Kibr. This is very horrible behavior for human beings in this life. My beloved students, what I written for the answer of B, you can elaborate more by add more 2 or 3 sentences as your wish. But I written there what I think. So my dear students, you have to understand what question is saying, and for explaining for that sentences, you have to read your book all the lines. Otherwise, you cannot give the proper answer. Now, for giving the time of the answer C, what is saying there? The outburst means expression. The outburst of which characteristics of akhlaqe zamima is the behavior of Mr. Shishir? Explain. Already I given you one clue. Mr. Shishir was becoming the envy. So that is expressed from Mr. Shishir. So you have to explain this. Now see answer. Envy is expressed by the behavior of Mr. Shishir, which is included in akhlaqe zamima. And as you know, akhlaqe zamima, what is called akhlaqe zamima, which is the bad behaviors in the human's behavior, all are included in akhlaqe zamima. So envy is the bad behavior. Actually, envy implies to feel jealous of others' prosperity, wealth, honor, good result, or high rank, etc. this is expressed by the behavior of Mr. Shishir. So this is the main answer. Now you have to explain about the envy. My dear students, now keep attention what I written in red ink. I didn't finish this answer, but I suggest you for writing, for completing this answer, and I given some clue how you will finish this answer. I written there, you will continue from here. It means after this you will continue. So you can add here few sentences of bad effects of envy, speech of Almighty Allah and Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and others. Others means you can write more sentences from yourself what you understand. And also minimum 10 sentences should write for answer of C. Students, this is the 3 marks question. So almost at least 10 sentences you should write. So according to the question, you have to write about the envy. So after writing this, you will continue this. And this is your HW also. When I will say about HW, you will be more clear. Now see the question number D. Explain the justification of the attitude of Mr. Naims in respect of the textbook. Okay, before explaining the D, I am telling about the number C. My dear students, I hope you understood from the C number answer. I just written 2 or 3 sentences. After that, you will continue that answer. You will finish the answer. And for writing the answer, you can follow my answer or you can write from anywhere, from yourself, from your mind. So for finishing that answer, you have to write some bad effects from that envy parts and some species. For example, in your book, there is Omin Sharri Hasidin Ida Hasad, that is related to the envy. Or another 2 hadiths is in your book has. So you can add there for writing, for completing the C answer. Now, D. So explain the justification of the attitude of Mr. Naims in respect of the textbook. So Mr. Naim was the patience person. He didn't impatience. So that about you have to write. So I written there full answer of D. Mr. Naim's behavior was accurate as it expressed one of the important quality of Akhlaq-e-Hamida, which was patience. My beloved students, as you know, patience is the very important attributes for the human beings, because many of the times we are being angry, we are being impatient. That's not good for the human being. So Mr. Naims was patience at that situation, which is included in Akhlaq-e-Hamida. The Arabic term of patience is, I written there as sabr, but it also called sabr. Both are correct. It means tolerance, firmness, self-control, etc. It is a key to success of human life. It means the patience is the key to the success of human life. Almighty Allah says, regarding this, Almighty Allah says, it is, I collected from your book, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, إنما يوفى الصابرون أجرهم بغير حساب. Meaning, of course, Allah will reward the patient in plenty. Plenty means a lot of. In Surah Zumar, Allah said it in ayat number 10. So according to the stream, Mr. Naim's agricultural farm was destroyed, but he did not become anxious about that. It means he didn't impatience. Rather, he was patient and thought that this is one kind of test from Almighty Allah. Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, Hazrat Ayub alayhi salam, Hazrat Yunus alayhi salam, even Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam, and all the prophets, I mean rest of all prophets and messengers, are faced more dangerous test from Almighty Allah. At that time, every prophets were patients, because impatience drives a man to failure in life. Thus, this is the last sentence. If you want to finish the answer, you can write like this. Thus, this discussion shows that Mr. Naim's attitude was correct, and one day he will pass the test, inshallah. So, my dear students, from that answer, you can understand, you can realize what is the significance of patience. You can write more from yourself, there is no problem. But you have to imply, you have to apply in your life. For any situation, you can be angry, but you shouldn't be impatient. When you will be a lot of extreme angry, our Prophet ﷺ is saying, you have to recite A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajim, or you perform the wuzu, or after wuzu you stand for performing the 2 rakat of nafal prayers. Then inshallah, after few minutes, the angry will be less. But never and ever be impatient. Because all the prophets, they faced this type of situation, I mean this type of test, and those are mu'min, they will face this type of test in the worldly life. That's then we can understood who are mu'min and who are the kafir. So that's all for that's all, my dear students. And there is the HW. See here, lecture number 11, this is going on. HW number 11, that is HW CQ 1 B and C from exercise chapter 4. It means, students, I told you, I written there the answer of B fully. You can write same as like me, but C number answer I didn't finish. So you have to finish from yourself after Mr. Shishir. So this is your HW B and C from exercise CQ 1 chapter 4. So that's all for today, my dear students. Keep patience in your life and advice to others for becoming patients. See you soon, inshallah, to abide by your parents and pray for us. Till then, assalamu alaikum.